Vancouver Fairview.
Honourable Speaker, as a result of high pollution levels in their wells, the Splatsin First Nation asked the Ministry of Environment for direct contact if further pollution occurred. So on February 16th, when Gracemar Farms spilled more than 120,000 gallons of liquid manure over the Splatsin's drinking water supply, one would expect the Ministry to contact Splatsin Chief Kupke Christian, government to government, just like the Information Commissioner ordered. Yet almost 2 weeks after the manure spill, there is still no direct contact and no sharing of information. How does the Environment Minister defend her failure to share crucial public health information with the Splatsin Nation, or does she just consider their rights and their health to be expendable?
Minister of the Environment.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I have worked with Chief Christian over many, many years. In fact, we worked very, very closely together when I was Minister of Children and Family Development. Thankfully, he has a lot more respect for me than you seem to show here today. Madam Speaker, I and staff have apologized for the poor communication that took place with respect to the breach of the lagoon, but it is absolutely incorrect that no one has reached out directly or been in direct contact with Splatsin. In fact, Madam Speaker, in planning for an upcoming community meeting on the 3rd, we have been in touch with them. We have been advised that Chief Christian won't be attending that. They have two members of their team who will be. So, Madam Speaker, how on earth we could organize all that with them without being in direct contact, I'm not sure how the member would possibly explain that.
Vancouver Fairview, on a supplemental.
Honourable Speaker, I would explain that simply by having been on a conference call with the Chief, with councillors, and with staff of the Splatsin last week, and confirming as of yesterday that there still had been no direct contact with the Nation. Honourable Speaker, the Splatsin First Nation and Hulkar residents have waited more than 3 years for this government to stop the serious water pollution that threatens their health. Yet all the minister has promised is more studies and committees and more meetings while pollution levels climb steadily higher. Honourable Speaker, most other jurisdictions around the world require an emergency management plan for all agricultural sewage lagoons, but not here in BC. Not here in BC, where when Gracemar Farm had a sewage spill, there was no emergency backup plan. Honourable Speaker, will the Environment Minister explain to British Columbians why she has not taken this one simple, obvious step to protect our drinking water?
Minister of the Environment.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. So let's not just talk about one step, let's talk about multiple steps that our ministry and the great people that work in our ministry have been taking over quite some time now. 9 pollution abatement or pollution prevention orders, work toward an area-based management plan, work with the various agricultural producers to ensure that they have the appropriate environmental impact assessments done for their farms. All of those being reviewed at public meetings, reports, multiple reports, being brought to the public meeting on March 3rd. And in fact, Madam Speaker, if you want to talk about reaching out to the Splatsin First Nation, I know personally that the member for Shuswap has directly called Chief Christian. I don't know if he has had a return call from that, but he has personally reached out. Our staff have personally reached out to the Splatsin and have had a response, which is how we have been able to plan their attendance at the meeting on Friday.